Okay, we're at Top Diner, and this is actually the first political candidate interview for the magazine.
Oh, great.
You know, thank you to Chris Pez for the request. I'm actually looking forward to this. I'm personally a registered independent, and it's a pleasure to be interviewing an independent candidate, Dennis Atiyah. Did I pronounce that correctly?
You did.
Okay, I want to make sure.
Dennis J. Atiyah as a write-in candidate.
Okay. A lot of people have a tendency to just not even think about write-in candidates, but the way our political system has gotten, it's time to spend more attention looking at all the candidates, not just the two sides.
No doubt. I would tell you, the way our political system is set up, regretfully, you have to kiss you know what to get on either party's ticket.
And also raise a lot of money.
Raise a lot of money too, but you have to get in and rub elbows with people that you might not necessarily want to. And you know, the reason why I could have very easily had gotten 1,000 signatures and ran as a Democrat or ran as an independent or even challenged Charlie Dent. But this write-in campaign is from the heart and it's for the people. And the main issue of this particular campaign is that so many people today don't know, men and teach, they don't know that the lawyers are operating our judicial system at the cost of the taxpayers.
When you told me, I was like, I didn't even know that.
Well, what I want to change is no different than every person that drives a car. Every time, like, I just put 10 bucks in down here at the Wawa. And, 10 gallons. I just paid $44, 40 cents a gallon in fuel tax. That fuel tax money goes on a federal, state, and local, and gets distributed to maintain the roads. When the lawyers go to court, we pay their taxes to go to court. So what I'm proposing in my legislation is for the lawyers to pay a legal tax, a tax that's gonna cut the cost of the court and take that burden off the citizens who are paying for the entire judicial system. Every time a lawyer walks into the courtroom, you and I and you, Chris, are paying for it. It's absurd.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly, you know, I have a farm and I have children. My tax burden is in the tens of thousands to take care of what I gotta take care of.
Right.
Now, what's fair is fair. Lawyers are making billions and billions and billions of dollars. You see their advertisements all over the place. Billboards, television,
internet.
Newspaper, internet. They're raking in billions and billions of dollars and we're paying for the court costs.
Right.
Look, all I want to do is have the lawyers pay their fair share of the costs associated with the legal system.
Okay.
And that's the main thrust of this campaign.
Okay. Now, when you say about, you know, every time you walk in a courtroom, a lot of people think only the criminal part of it, but there's also the civil part of it, and that's also,
Listen, regretfully, I've been in court. It, no matter what you lose, the Holy Scriptures tells us avoid court. But what you're saying is you're exactly right. These big insurance companies and these big corporations, they'll challenge and attack a regular citizen and try to drag them out, knowing that the court costs are being paid by you and I.
Yeah.
So they have nothing to lose.
Yeah.
And then on top of that, you get these poor jurors go in and they get $10, $20 a day. And the lawyers are making billions.
I actually in the mid-90s, I was actually one time jury duty, federal court, down in Philadelphia. So I actually know what you're talking about as far as...
Listen, it's a comedy.
Yeah.
Our system has the jurors working for $10 or $20 a day while the lawyers are making billions.
Yeah.
Billions of dollars.
And in the meantime, they're losing the money off their jobs, off what they'd be making for the jobs throughout that.
Now you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
So I'm saying this, look, man, I love God. I love Jesus. I live for them, okay? And I'm sweating right now thinking that how are these politicians and lawyers keeping this hush that the average person don't know? You know why? They're the ones making all the money.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't want to leave the cat.
Right.
Out of that.
Yeah.
So my whole point is, you know, I want every single person who votes and has that glimmer of hope that you were talking about to vote for me.
Okay.
Because I am going to go. I wore my steel tip boots today. All right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to go down there and not in loafers. You know, lawyers and politicians all wear loafers. You understand? And suits. Charlie Dent. Okay? He's been a career politician. He spent his life in politics. I got a pair of steel tip boots on. And let me show you.
Okay, look. Actually, I got it.
Come on up here. Look. Okay. In my boot. Mm-hmm. It's all beat up.
Yeah.
For horse, right?
Uh-huh.
You hear that? That's a steel tip boot. All right? What I'm going to do with that, if you folks write me in, I'm going to go down to Washington, D.C. and kick some you know what. Okay? It's time to straighten out these career politicians. It's time to straighten out these lawyers and get the lawyers to pay for the court judicial costs and lower the cost of politicians. Charlie Dent makes $175,000 a year. He has five offices. He spends his 2 years, you know what he does? If you saw my finger in that slip.
Yeah.
I'm going to federally fund stocking of deer and pheasant and trout, and I want people back out fishing and hunting, right?
Yeah.
He don't fish or hunt. He spends his time politicking, campaigning on the taxpayer's dollar.
Mm-hmm.
He gets paid $350,000 he'll get. And all he does is spend the whole time rubbing elbows with big corporations, China. And let's talk about China. You know, that's one of the biggest problems with America, China. Okay, with their low costs and cheap things and bad products, poisoning our pets, poisoning human beings, poisoning the air. And I'm going to stop that, and I'm going to bring manufacturing jobs right here to America. And we talk.
Mm-hmm.
We talk about big jobs, okay? We're going to break those oil tycoons and stop them from running our country with those Sunni Muslims and the rest of them overseas, okay? And we're going to bring energy technologies. That's what we talk about.
You're a farmer. You know more about that than most people do.
There is some real advanced technologies right now in agriculture that need to be developed. And really, really, millions of jobs could be created just on the agriculture and the environmental side. My son's a Cornell student. And I will tell you, there's some real amazing things, and I don't really have time to get into it with you. Because I really want to stay focused.
People can look that up on their own time.
Yeah. I really want to stay focused on my main purpose, and that's straightening out the lawyers and the politicians.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the main reason I'm running. And my campaign slogan, men, is that every vote is a victory. Everyone that votes for me is sending a message to Washington, D.C. Look, we have nothing. We have enough of these deadlocks. You always hear them all the time, this deadlock. Look, I'm a former wrestler. I'm going to go in headlock.
I like that. I like that.
I'm going to go down there. Forget about the deadlocks. Between the Democrats and Republicans. I'm going to go down there and throw some headlocks.
Well, I'll be honest with you. Back in the primaries, okay, I totally forgot that if you're an independent, you couldn't register in the primary. So after I found out, after I went to a polling place and they called up the main office and said, well, you're an independent, you can't vote. I actually did an editorial and I said, you know what? I said, it's time to end this two-party stuff. I said, it's time for people to vote for who they feel is going to be the best person for the job. Forget about the two-party. Vote for the person, not the party.
You said it. You said it. And really, that's the biggest problem with American politics. Okay? People grow up being a Democrat. Their parents were Democrats. And same thing on the Republican side.
Yeah.
Okay? And what you said, you know, you said it all. You know, we have to vote for what's best for our country.
Right.
What's best for the citizens of our country. And this particular legislation that I'm going to pass is good for everybody. It's good for the poor. It's good for the rich. It's good for the Democrat. It's good for the Republican. You understand?
Yeah.
Making the lawyers pay their dues. I've probably talked to close to 1,000 people. I told you that.
Yeah.
Okay? 998 people had a mixed, but wow, I can't believe that.
Brilliant.
Yeah, you saw my reaction when so.
I can't believe that we're paying for the judicial system.
Yeah.
Wow, that sounds like a great idea. Two people didn't like the idea. One was married to a lawyer, and the other one was a lawyer.
Makes sense.
Are you hearing me?
Yeah, makes sense.
So you got it's overwhelming.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm gonna leave with is this: you know. I want to stay focused on the whole legal tax issue.
Mm-hmm.
That's the main thrust. And by people writing me in, every vote is a victory because they're going to send a message to Washington, D.C. that that is what we want.
Mm-hmm.
We want to lower our tax burden for every single citizen in this country. And what I'm talking about, and you gotta understand this. This is going to save every taxpayer thousands and thousands of dollars. Thousands, I'm talking. Every single taxpayer.
Mm-hmm.
And their children and their children's children forever. Forever.
Yeah.
The judicial system in America needs to be changed that is the cost of those who work and make billions of dollars in it.
Mm-hmm.
And that is really what the main thrust is. And by voting for me, and write me in, now you gotta write me in, it's a little complicated. You go to the voting booth, it's gonna take you maybe a minute, okay? But that minute can change history.
Mm-hmm.
And what I and here's what I wanna leave the listeners with, and you and this beautiful little boy right here. Alright? That there's been, listen.
Yes, you're going to be in the video.
Listen, and I want to tell you this, man. I'm a history major. I graduated with a history degree and an economics degree.
Okay.
From the University of Pittsburgh.
Very nice.
And I will tell you this. My history side tells me that General George Washington hung out in Bethlehem. And a lot of the men that fought in the Revolutionary War were from our district.
Right.
Right here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Then we had regretfully one of the worst wars ever, the Civil War. And Gettysburg. We're talking about the other side.
Right.
Of our district. In Dauphin County, electorate that we're hopefully gonna watch this. And the Harrisburg area. They were in the Civil War, and people from our area fought the Civil War. The troops came right through, Abraham Lincoln, it came right through the district. Right?
Yeah.
Now, those were two major wars. I'm talking about a tax revolution. I'm talking about every single citizen in this country, okay, benefiting from this tax revolution that's starting right in this little table.
Yeah.
Are you understanding me?
Yeah.
The people need to vote. They need to take the time and write in Dennis J A T I Y E H.
And there'll be a link right to your web, right to everything, right in your video article.
Just write it in.
Uh-huh.
Okay, it's that simple. And every single vote is a victory. And then the last thing I'm going to leave you with, we have a district that has the beautiful town of Bethlehem, the birthplace of Jesus, the Messiah,
mm-hmm.
the Son of God. And we have the Jordan Creek, which we fish.
Yep. Talking about. I still remember all the best fishing spots along there.
I fished the Jordan Creek.
Yeah.
You know? John the Baptist baptized Jesus Christ, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we have some beautiful godly names. We have two revolutionary wars in the root of our district, okay? And I would like to pray and hope that we can start a tax revolution in this district that will change the way our entire country taxes the citizens, and every single citizen will benefit from it. And that burden will fairly, not unfairly, be put on the men and women, the lawyers, the law firms that use that court system.
Yep.
Dennis, you said alarming. I'm sorry to interject, but you said about 85% never even going to court.
The statistics show that about 85% to 90% of Americans never use the court system, and yet they're paying for it.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, we need to shift that burden. And look, if the 10 or 15% that use it, the lawyers, were that broke and they were working for peanut money, and, you know, you have to look at it.
Yeah.
But they're making billions and billions and billions of dollars. And my whole premise is what's fear is fear.
Mm-hmm.
We pay a fuel tax to use the roads. Lawyers pay a legal tax to use the courts.
Yeah, we even pay school tax for our kids to go to school.
Same premise.
You know? Yeah.
It's a fear and a fair and righteous tax proposal that I, me, Dennis Atiyah, will go down to Washington, D.C. with my steel tip boots, okay, and my old headlocks,
yeah,
my hips, right? and I will kick some, and I will break the deadlocks, and I'll do some headlocks.
Now, if you don't mind me asking, well, I'd actually like to wind this out on this question. It was the first question I asked you. This is something totally, you know, on a broader scale, more basic scale. With our government and the way people everywhere from your local level on up to you know, Washington, whether it's right or not, we get screwed. No matter what the people want, we get screwed. Why would people have a reason? Why would people have a reason to? And no offense, please do not take offense. But what reason would people have to believe in any candidate or in our system of government again and go out and vote? The last election, Allentown had a 10% turnout. The last election, 10% of this is what, the fourth largest city in the state. So that tells you right there on a local level, people just think that we're going that, okay, what, no matter which way I vote, so what reason would people have to go out, whether it's for you or any candidate, to go out there and say, you know what, I'm going to take the time, I'm going to learn about what each candidate is going to try to do for me, and I'm going to go out there and vote, and let's turn this country around finally. And please do not take offense.
I'm going to tell you this. That's one of the reasons I didn't become a Democrat or a Republican, or even ran on independent ticket. I want no association with the past. Now, does that mean that every single politician is bad? No, that doesn't mean that. Okay? It means that our system of being of these deadlocks, mm-hmm. that and because they're loyal to the Republican Party or loyal to the Democratic Party, they get in these deadlocks and nothing happens. They call it political football. Political football. Now, Pezzi, you know this. I played football with some of the greatest football players ever to play the game.
Okay.
Okay? One of them being Dan Marino. He's a teammate of mine. Okay? Now, look. I hit hard. And when I played football, you guys, Dan, and all my teammates, I hit hard.
Okay.
Me, for the citizens, I'm going to hit hard. I'm going to hit China hard. I'm going to hit the lawyers hard and make them pay illegal tax. I'm going to hit all of those bullshitters that want to play these political football games, okay? And I'm going to tackle them, and I'm going to straighten it out the best that I can. So I'm going to give it my all.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to give it my all for every single citizen that when they write me in, and remember one thing, with God, all things are possible. I'm a little underdog right now. I'm going up against this career politician.
I have an indie online magazine in the area that goes up against the major media, so I know exactly where you're coming from.
So I would tell you, my answer would be, you know, that hope is here, man. Hope in Jesus Christ, hope in God. And I'm going to do everything that represents that. And one of them is representing the people.
Okay.
And I understand that there are so many people.
By the way, none of this is scripted. All this is, you know, not one word of this is scripted. Yeah.
I have 8 children, man. I love children. I always told my wife I wish I had 20. But I mean that, okay? Listen, I'm gonna say this, that's why I'm here.
Mm-hmm.
For the children.
Okay. For the future.
For the children.
Yeah, for our future.
I want my children to live in a less of a tax burden. You know, when you see people losing their homes and losing everything they have because they can't pay the taxes, you understand?
Yeah.
It's heartbreaking. And my wife and I, we struggle to pay our own taxes. Mm-hmm. So I would tell you, you know, I feel the people. My mom raised 7 of us on her own. My mom raised 7 of us on her own.
Okay.
You understand?
Yes.
Plus she raised 15 right there. 16 right there.
I didn't live, you know, some silver spoon saving.
Right.
I've been, you know, in difficult situations financially in my life, and my hope is for our children to have less of a tax burden, so they can enjoy their lives a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's my main thrust. I'm gonna cut taxes
okay. For
every citizen in the country. That's where I'm gonna start. And I told you, I'm gonna headlock the deadlock, and I'm gonna with my steel tip boots. I'm gonna kick with my steel tip boots. I'm gonna kick some. All right.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for your time. I greatly appreciate it.
Right in, Dennis Atia.
And by the way, what did you? I always turned it around. What did you think of the interview and the way I did it in this style?
I would tell you. I
can take the feedback just as well.
I like the natural.
I would tell you this. You know, if I said anything to offend anybody, forgive me.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
If I'm not your standard wearing a tie politician with blonde hair and blue eyes and smiling, and that's one thing that always bothers me about politicians, they're always smiling, okay? So I'm myself.
Yeah.
I'm not smiling.
I think this is what people want people ready for.
Well, hey, listen. If I was outside, I would use my steel-tipped boots and kick a tree because that's how pissed off I am.
Yeah.
You know, getting back to the voters all being agitated and don't want to vote.
Right.
They feel hopeless. But
when you're there, the write-in takes an extra minute,
listen,
right?
Yeah. Listen, it's going to take you about a minute to do this. Write in Dennis, D-E-N-N-I-S, J-A-T-I-Y-E-H, and your vote is a victory. You go to the booth, at the Congress, you pull it up and you write in Dennis J. Atia. Write my name in. It's going to take you a minute, but guess what? You know, they always talk about people buying votes. Okay? This particular situation, when I change the tax structure of the judicial system, you're going to save yourself and your families thousands of dollars. I'm not buying your vote. What I'm telling you is, the minute or two that you go out of your way for it, it's gonna save you and your family and your children thousands.
Okay.
So do it for your good.
Well, thank you very much for your time.